Hello, it's Jeanette with GeoAmazing Paper Crafts. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm back with another video tutorial, and today I'm going to show you how I put together this card here using what I call stencils and Stampin' Up! Calls pattern masks. But they have some beautiful designs in their collection, and of course I use some other dyes and sentiment, but I'm going to show you how easy it is to put this card together. And if you notice, I'm using all of the in colors that will be retiring on June 3rd. So I hope that you can get those inks out and stamp along with me or color along with me. So if you want to see how I made this card, just continue watching. So to begin, I'm going to start with our card base. And the card base measures 8.5 by 5.5, and I've scored it at 4.25. And I just want to take my bone folder, and I want to give it a nice crease. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Scattered Sequence Dynamic Textured Impressions Embossing Folder. Now, isn't that a mouthful? Now, this is one that I got free during celebrations, and I'm surprised that I never thought of getting this one before, because it is absolutely the coolest embossing folder, because these little specks actually look like little sequences, and it's so cool. So I'm just going to be putting it in my Big Shot partially, okay? I just want half of the card. And I really don't even need half the card. Probably going to lower it down to about here. Maybe here. Okay. And my sandwich is going to consist of the Big Shot platform. You don't need that thinner one. And you need to go through your Big Shot with one cutting plate like this. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this to the Big Shot, or you can take it to any of your die cutting machines. Now, I got to make sure I didn't move this. And I did, so let me straighten it out. And I will be right back. So look at this really cool sequence embossing. It is so cool. I love it. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is start working on putting the decoration on my shimmer paper. And that's what I am using, shimmer paper. And I'm not sure if you'll be able to see how this shimmers in this light. But that's what shimmer paper is. It's a little bit thicker than our normal cardstock. And it's really good for applying a lot of ink or even watercolor paints. So we're going to go ahead and start, but what I'm going to use to hold my paper and stencil down is my Stamparatus. That's right, my Stamparatus. And here it is right here. Let's hope the glare doesn't get too badly. Let me move my lamp over just a little bit. There we go. Take some of the glare out. Okay, so I call them stencils, but Stampin' Up! Calls them pattern party decorative masks. Okay, and so the one that I'm going to use, let's see, there's four of them in here. Let me show you the four that come with this. You get this one, and this is the one I'm going to use. Okay, and then you also have the brick pattern. Isn't that cool? And then you have this lovely, I guess they're little decorative squares, kind of a lacy lattice type design. And then you have the clouds. So you can make some pretty shaded clouds with this. But like I said, I'm going to be using my Stamparatus to hold everything down. And now I want this decorative mask to be right in the corner. Okay. Oh, I got something on my... I have something on my Stamparatus there. So it's like right here in the corner, and I am going to hold it down like that. Now I'm going to do my best to center this piece. And by the way, this piece measures 5.5 by 3 inches. And I will be trimming it down after I color it, but I want to make sure that I am getting this right in the middle where I need it to be, so that it gives me equal decorations on all sides. So I'll fast forward this part because this may take me just a minute to get this perfectly even. Now that looks pretty good to me, so I'm going to take my other magnet. And these magnets are very strong, and it's going to hold my paper in there. Okay, so now that I've got this positioned, I can start doing some of my stenciling or my coloring. And I'm going to be using all of the retiring colors. We have Fresh Fig. I'm going to also be using my little sponge daubers. So we got Fresh Fig. We have Berry Burst. We have Powder Pink. We have Lemon Lime Twist. And we have Tranquil Tide. And these are all the colors that will be retiring. I think June 3rd is the last day you'll be able to order these, and the inks too. So I'm kind of sad to see these colors go, because yes, they've been around for a couple of years, but I have been in love with every single one of these colors. So let's get going. I'm going to open this up, and I'm just going to go ahead straight from the ink pad. I'm going to do some daubing here, and I want just the middle and a little bit of the next little design colored in the Fresh Fig. And I kind of want to go dark, and so I'm not actually rubbing because I don't want to mess my sponge up. I'm just pouncing, and I kind of just want to go just a little darker in the middle, because I know you noticed that the Berry Burst color is kind of just a lighter version of this fresh Fig, a little bit more red. Okay, I am done with that. Now I'm going to come in. I'm going to close this before I get my hand in it. I'm going to go with my Berry Burst. Let's open this up. Let's get another sponge dauber. And I'm going to tap, tap, tap. And then I am going to go right next to where I left off, kind of getting, you know, over that, just a little bit of the edge of where I stopped with the Fresh Fig. But I want the next design and a little bit of this design right here with the Fresh Fig. I mean, with the Berry Burst, not the Fresh Fig. I already used the Fresh Fig. Okay. Okay, let's see. Now, I think that's enough. All right, now let's close this one up. And then I'm going to use the Powder Pink. So as you can see, we're kind of going lighter and lighter. And the Powder Pink, you're not going to be able to see it too much because it's so light, but it's there. I could see it pretty good. I'm going to finish off this design right here and go a little bit into the next design with the Powder Pink. And just tap, 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 and I hope it's not shaking the camera when I do this. I guess I'll know when I do some editing here if it shakes too much. Then I'll fast forward. Okay, so I've got some Powder Pink now on this. And then the next color that I'm going to go with, close that one up. The next color is going to be the Lemon Lime Twist. This is such a beautiful green. Oh, I just absolutely love this green. Okay. And I'm going to go just to the edge of where I stopped with that Powder Pink. Okay. And don't worry if you're not completely even with all of your colors. It's going to still look very, very beautiful. I've made this design several times, and every one of them is so pretty. just the way the colors blend together. And I absolutely love all of these colors. And so what's not to love about designs combining these colors? Okay, so I think I got enough lemon lime twist, and you can go back in and make things darker if you want. No problem there. All right, I'm gonna shut this one up and close that one up rather. Don't shut it up because it's not talking. Although these colors speak loudly. Okay, the next is the Tranquil Tide, and we're gonna finish it off with Tranquil Tide. Kind of blending with that green. And I kind of want to go a little darker with the Tranquil Tide. Yeah, so yeah, you want to hurry up and get all your ink refills for these if you've already got the pads, because once they're gone, they are gone. Once they retire, you know, you might be able to find somebody selling theirs on eBay, but they're going to want a lot of money for them. Any retired things on eBay that you see, they seem to just kind of want like twice as much as what Stampin' Up! Sold them for. So you kind of got to be careful there. Get it while you can through Stampin' Up! And don't forget, Stampin' Up! Has rewards for you if you spend over $150, which is very easy for me to do. And I get to use my rewards for free stuff. And who doesn't love free stuff, right? Okay. All right, now I'm going to go back in with my lemon lime. I just kind of want to make some more adjustments with this lemon lime right here. I'm going to put a little bit of lemon lime on these two designs over here. Okay. All right. I think I'm pretty much done with my stenciling here. I'm not going to reveal just yet, because what I'd like to do also is I would like to just make it sparkle. And I know that it is on that glimmer paper, but I think I might just brush a little bit of Wink Estella on some of this. Just make it sparkle a little bit more, okay? And now with Wink Estella, it's kind of a water-based paint. So what you wanna do when you're shifting from one color to the next, you're gonna wanna brush off a little bit on your pad, just so that you're not transferring a lot of that color to the next color. Then you'll kind of ruin it. Then it'll be muddy. Okay. And I can see how this color is kind of blending. So I'm just kind of taking some of that color off before I go into the next color. Okay. And I absolutely love the Wink of Stella. Oh my goodness, it's really making it shiny. Wink of Stella is my favorite thing to make things sparkle. And who doesn't love bling, right? Okay, let's do this reveal now. Let's take off this magnet and pull up the stencil, and look at that. Isn't that pretty? Okay, so we're going to go ahead and trim this a little bit, and then I'm going to come back and show you what I'm going to do to finish off my card. So I did trim this down, and I believe it now measures, I don't have I don't have the right ruler on here. I don't have the other grid pad that Stampin' Up! Sells. I have this new pretty grid pad. This looks like it measures 2 3/8 by 5.5. I didn't cut any off on the sides. Okay, but I also wanted to show you how easy it is to clean up your the ink off of your Stamparatus. I'm just using a little baby wipe, and you can also do that with your little masks here. Probably going to need just still wipe up my Stamparatus, and it comes really clean. Or you could just take these and run them under water and pat them dry. So they're very easy to maintain. So I'm going to move this out of the way, and we're going to work on the rest of the card. Okay, so I have a piece of black cardstock here. This is basic black, and it measures 4.25 by 5.5, but I don't need all of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, to make this a nice pretty edge, I'm going to take the delicate lace edgelets, and what I want to do is I want to take this to the big shot like that, and then I'll determine how much to cut off or how much to do the edge on the other side. So pretty much this will cut just the edge of it. This part here does not have a blade. It's only cutting the edge. That's why they call these edgelets, because they only cut off the edge. And now I want to get a piece of tape to make sure I've got this nice and straight. And I'm going to change up, instead of using the the platform, I'm going to use the magnetic platform, if I could find what I did with it. Here it is. Okay, so it's going to be my magnetic platform, one plate, my paper with the die, and we're going to put these away for now. And this is my sandwich. I'm taking it to the big shot. I'll be right back. Okay, let's take this off of the plate here and see what we got. I'm going to have all of these little pieces here, but that's what makes our design so pretty. Okay, see this beautiful edge we have? Okay, now I'm going to take this to the trash can here. And dump some of this off. And I'm going to go ahead and put this on here and determine how much of that design I want showing. And I think, I don't know, I think I like it all, but I do need to hide some of it so I can have room for my sentiment. So I'm going to go just to those squares. And so that's going to help me determine where to put this on this side here. So if I want to make sure that those squares are showing, this is where I'm going to put it, right here. I think, yeah. Well, either way, we're going to make sure that it's even on both sides, and making sure that I've got enough of a gap too. So that's pretty much where I want it. And I am going to just make sure that I've got it even. Let me measure here and make sure I've got it even on both sides. Okay, that's 2.25 here, up here. 2.25, and down here we want 2.25, close enough. I didn't do too bad. And I'm going to put my tape on here. I'm going to take this back to the big shot with this sandwich, and I will be right back. If they didn't all come out, you know, there's a tool that you can use, the brush tool, but I pretty much got most of them out. So I'm just going to take my paper piercing tool and just make sure that all of that design is out. Let me clean off all these little things that look like bugs. Oh, okay, that's fine. Okay, so we have this here, and now I'm going to just go ahead and attach this and try to make it look as even as possible. showing off as much of that design on the edges as possible. Okay, so we're going to do that with Tombow Mono multi-purpose liquid glue. Oh, I gotta clean my tip off here, and we're just going to put it all over the back of this. Okay. And let's try to get this even on both sides with even amounts of the design showing. Can we do that? Needs to get lowered on this side. And if it's not perfect, it's okay. It's, you know, it's handmade, right? Okay. And like I say, we can trim off whatever doesn't work on the sides. Slightly trim. Okay, now it's time to attach it to my card here. And because this has got some raised design on this from the embossing, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and put some more mono Tombow Mono adhesive glue on the back here. Because it's still going to, all those little embossing raises are going to give it a little bit of dimension. So I'm not going to use any dimensionals for this. Okay. And that's where I'm putting that, right there. I got to make sure. Let me make sure I'm all the way up. Okay. Isn't that pretty? Okay, now all we need to do is put our sentiment on here and do a little bit more decorating. All right, I'm pressing that down to make sure that it's going to stay. Okay, so for my sentiment, I have chosen to use a sentiment from the Woodwards. I like this, A Note for You, and I've got that on a block, and this is block C, and I'm going to be using some Memento Tuxedo black ink for that. And I do still have a little piece of the shimmer paper. I wish that you could see the shimmer on here. You see it in a certain light and it's very pretty. Okay, and for the actual tag, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this die from Bunch of Banners Framelits. But I want to stamp this first to make sure I have it in the right position so that I could die cut this. I'm going to put my card away for now. And we're just going to stamp this. Okay. And I'm doing it at the catty corner because I want that die to fit. There we go. Nice and crisp. And we're going to put this die here. And we're going to take our platform, our plate, this, the paper, the die, and I'm making sure that it's in the center. I'm going to use a little bit more tape to make sure it doesn't jump around on this magnetic platform because that's what magnets do. Okay, let me close this up. All right, let's take this to the Big Shot. Okay, so I've got my tag, but I'm going to also do this die on some black because this tag actually cuts the outside. See, it's stuck on my plate here. It's time to change out my bottom plate. But I'm not going to use this. I want to use this tag in black. So do you see this piece that I was left over after I cut that design? I'm going to go ahead and cut this straight up. I'm all fingers and thumbs here. Okay. Here we go. I'm just going to go ahead and cut this out of that. Take that to my die cutting machine. Okay, and now I now have this piece here, and this fits right in there perfectly. So I'm just going to put a little piece of tape on the back to make sure it doesn't shift. And we are going to put this die away. Okay. I'm just going to set that aside. We're going to put this away, and we'll clean up after we're all done. Okay. I'm going to put that away over there. Just clearing up my spaces here so that I don't have all kinds of trash around. All right, here we go. We've got to kind of tape this together so that it doesn't shift, and I'm just going to use a tiny little piece of tape on here. There we go. See that right there? Just use a tiny piece of tape. And now I am going to use some dimensionals, Stampin' Dimensionals, to hold this up. One on one side and one on the other side. And we're going to try to center this the best we can. And I do have a center point that I can kind of go by. This one here. I haven't covered that up yet. Let's get these dimensionals, the backer paper off of the dimensionals. And let's put this down. Try to center it the best we can. About maybe a quarter of an inch from the bottom. There we go. Okay, I love it. Okay, now let's put some more decoration on here. I'm going to go ahead and use some sequins since, you know, we've got the sequins embossing folder. And the sequins that I'm going to use is from the basic, no, which one did I want to use? The Gingham Gala Adhesive Backed Sequins. Okay. That's another mouthful. And I think what I want to use for this is, I think this is the balmy blue one. Yeah, because it's got a lot of iridescent. And that's what I want. I want some iridescent on here. Since some of it already sparkles anyway, let's continue with this sparkle. Now, what do I want? I think I want to use these little flowers here. I haven't used those yet. Or do I? You know what? I think I'm going to go ahead and just go with the regular sequins. And I'm going to put one in the middle here. Okay. And I can put as many as I want all over the place if I wanted to. But I think I'm just going to go with three. One on each side of this tag. And that one in the middle. Okay. And I'm going to call this project done. See how easy it is to create when you've got the right tools? And don't forget, these colors, these in colors, as you can see, I kind of smeared that there. But when you make yours, you're going to be a lot neater than mine, right? Okay. So I hope that you enjoyed watching me make this, and I hope that you would try it too with your Stampin' Up! Supplies or any supplies where you can make this work. But I just love the idea of using the Stamparatus other than for stamping, using it to hold down your stencils, you know, and holding down your card so that you can center things. It's a marvelous tool. So don't go out and get expensive tools for that. You've already got your Stamparatus or your stamping platform that's got a magnetic base on it. Just use that. Okay, so I hope that you try this. If you need any of the tools and the supplies that I use for this video, I'm going to list them down in the description, and they'll also be listed in my blog. And if you don't have a demonstrator, I would love to be your demonstrator. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell so that you could get notified every time I put a new video up. Okay? So once again, I am Jeanette with GeoMazing Paper Crafts. And you make it a great day. Bye-bye.